On 23rd December 1926, Swami Shuddhanand was resting after his activities of Shuddhi. He was also recuperating after an attack of bronchial pneumonia. Abdul Rashid, a man covered in a blanket, came to meet Swamiji. The attendant present there tried to explain Swamiji's ill health, but Abdul was adamant on his meeting Swamiji. With a lot of hesitation and the permission of Swamiji, Abdul was admitted into Swamiji's room. When the attendant went away to bring a glass of water for Abdul, he took out his revolver and fired 2 rounds on Swamiji. Swamiji was murdered. In 1919 and 1920, the Khilafat movement and the Moplah genocide of Hindus were at its peak. These movements also converted several Hindus to Islam. On the other hand, Christian missionaries were also converting several Hindus for some money. Swami Shuddhanand, an Arya Samaj leader, decided to start Shuddhi, a process of reconversion of those Hindus who were forcibly converted. Swamiji had managed to reconvert almost 60,000 Hindus. He managed to get back Malkana Rajputs and Dalit Muslims back to Hinduism. This obviously irked the Muslims and Christian missionaries. Throughout the journey of Swamiji's process of Shuddhi, M.K. Gandhi was very unhappy and opposed Swamiji on the reconversion of such people. Swamiji had agreed to stop reconversion only if the Muslims stopped their tabligh. Tabligh is a mandatory duty in Islam to convert the non-Muslims to Muslims. M.K. Gandhi could never argue with Swamiji on this. Though Swamiji had supported several movements of M.K. Gandhi, there were several differences of opinions between them. Swamiji was the only Hindu sannyasi who addressed huge gatherings from the minarets of the main Jama Masjid in Delhi for national solidarity, Vedic Dharma. He always started his speech with Vedic mantras. It was mainly after the Hindu genocide by the Moplah in 1920, Swamiji left the Congress and joined Hindu Mahasabha. He not only advocated Shuddhi, but also started Gurukuls. The growth of Hindu nationalist movement under the Hindu Mahasabha and Arya Samaj was completely opposed by the Congress ideology then. For this fierce campaign of Shuddhi, Swamiji was assassinated. After Swamiji's death, M.K. Gandhi made the following remarks: "Let us pray to God that we may understand the real meaning of this assassination. Let the Hindus remain peaceful and refrain from seeking revenge for this murder. Let them not think that the two communities are now enemies of each other and that unity is no longer possible." He also said, Swamiji asked his servant to admit Abdul Rashid because God had willed to show there through the greatness of Swamiji and the glory of Hinduism. M.K. Gandhi referred to Abdul Rashid, the assassin of Swamiji, as his dear brother and tried to justify this several times. Interestingly, some years later, Harilal Gandhi, the eldest son of Gandhi, embraced Islam at Jama Masjid in Bombay. This came as a shock to the entire nation, including his own family. Islamic preachers took great pride in converting Harilal Gandhi to his new name, Abdullah. It's only on Kasturba Gandhi's request that Arya Samaj convinced Harilal to reconvert back to Hinduism. Interestingly, even after 95 years of Swami Shuddhanand's death, Shuddhi continues as one of the activities of Arya Samaj. Indicaidias pays an emotional tribute to a Mahatma of Bharat, Swami Shuddhanand, on his 95th death anniversary. Unlike other sannyasis who withdraw from life, Swami Shuddhanandji ventured into the hullabaloo of active life and started and led a movement to reform and rejuvenate Hinduism.